Hey guys, so this is it. This is my top three boss fights that you know that I really enjoyed in the whole Metal Gear franchise. So I've mentioned seven so far. Seven of my favorite boss fights so far, and you'll notice that none of those bosses come from Metal Gear Solid 3. And Metal Gear Solid 3 is considered by many people to have like the best boss fights in the series. And so, the reason is because two of those bosses are in my top three. My top three. Number three is the boss from Metal Gear Solid 3. The emotional impact is really big on this boss. But the gameplay itself is pretty interesting. You know, you're in a field of just this white flowers, so you can actually use your camouflage to blend yourself to the environment. Now, the boss, even if you do the best you can, your camo index will only get you so far. I think the highest you can get is like 65% or 70%, even with the snow camouflage. So you're not perfectly blended into the environment. But the boss herself is using a white suit. So it's like a cat and mouse game. Like, do you discover her first or does she discover you first? So it's a sniping match, but also like a, you know, stealth versus stealth. That's what I love about this fight. And CQC versus CQC. Also, although the boss has such an upper hand on this, if the boss discovers you and runs at you, brace yourself because you're mostly going to break a bone. Most likely, you're going to break a bone because making the timing perfectly to counter her CQC, pretty difficult. I know many people have, I've watched some, you know, amazing Japanese players of Metal Gear Solid 3 just defeat the boss using nothing but CQC. I think that's insane. Because I don't think I could ever do that. I am not good as the timing on that to be able to do that. But you can become an expert on the timing of the CQC move. It's a very fun boss fight. You have a time limit on this boss fight, which also makes things even more intense. You have to beat the boss in 10 minutes. After 5 minutes pass, Snake Eater music plays in the background. So that makes it even more epic. You know, it's just such an epic boss fight. But the most impactful moment is after the boss fight, as is usually the case with many Metal Gear Solid games. Many Metal Gear boss fight, it's the after the boss fight that has you going like, holy shit, that just happened. You have to shoot the boss. You have to do it. The game doesn't have a cutscene where Snake shoots the boss. You have to actually end the life of the boss. There's no other option to do it. It's one of the most emotionally tear-jerking moments ever. Especially if you know the ending to Metal Gear Solid 3, you don't want to kill the boss, but you have to. And that's what makes it such a powerful moment in Metal Gear history. The boss fight. Like, it still gets me chills just thinking about it, and that's why it's my number 3. Number 2, also from Metal Gear Solid 3, the end. One of the best, pretty much the best sniping boss fight in the entire franchise. And there's a couple in the series. You know, there's a sniping boss fight against Crying Wolf, against Sniper Wolf 2 times. Am I forgetting another sniping fight? Don't think so. I think those are the 3 sniping boss fights. The end is amazing because you're playing it in such a large area. This is like a really drawn out boss fight. The first time I played this boss fight, it took me like 2 hours to actually defeat this guy. And it's such an intense boss fight. You don't know where this guy is. His camouflage works so well in this jungle environment. He just uses a tranquilizer gun, so your life is not threatened, but you don't want to be defeated by this guy. I don't know, like, I don't think I have to explain too much why this is my number 2, because for most people, for many people, the end is the number 1 boss fight in the series. Which makes my number 1 probably a little bit controversial for many of you guys. I think many of you guys will not agree with my number 1 choice. But number 2, many people will think, like, that should be number 1, the end. It's freaking awesome boss fights, and the way you can defeat him. You know, there's so many options, you know? You can snipe him before even the boss fight when he's in the wheelchair, and that's it. You know, you can manipulate the time clock of your PlayStation 2, that makes him just die of old age because he's so freaking old. You can hold him up a couple of times, you know, if you manage to sneak up behind the sniper. And, you know, this is where you really use the tools of combat. You know, you use your directional microphone, you use your thermal goggle to track his footprints in this vast, large area. He also starts regenerating health, stamina. If you're doing a stamina kill and not an actual kill, this matters. If you got it down to like 2 bars, if you don't find him quickly enough, he will regenerate all of his stamina, making your effort pointless, and you have to pretty much start from the beginning again. That makes this battle, again, really intense, really drawn out. One of the best sniping experiences in gaming, I think. Even though it's very unrealistic if you compare it to a game like, you know, Sniper Elite or whatever. Not super realistic, but it's just you just feel like a really great sniper in this battle. And that's why it's my number 2. Number 1, I think it's going to be quite controversial for me. But before I get to number 1, let me do the thing that people usually do all the time, is recap. So number 10 for me was Big Boss from Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake. Number 9 was Psycho Mantis from Metal Gear Solid 1. Number 8, Crying Wolf from Metal Gear Solid 4. Number 7, Peace Walker, the robot, the Metal Gear from Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. Number 6, Fight Against Rex from Metal Gear Solid 1. Number 5, Fight Against Rey while piloting a Metal Gear Rex in Metal Gear Solid 4. I don't know, I get so excited saying that because it was such an exciting thing. Number 4, Gray Fox in Metal Gear Solid 1. Number 3, The Boss in Metal Gear Solid 3. Number 2, The End in Metal Gear Solid 3. And number 1 for me is Liquid Ocelot from Metal Gear Solid 4. The final boss fight of pretty much the series. If we're not including Peace Walker and Ground Zeroes and whatever, the whole 1, 2, 3, 4 saga, Liquid Ocelot is the final boss fight of that saga. Or just Ocelot, actually. I think, again, this is the emotional connection. Just being in the final boss fight, I think, also has an impact, too. But it's before the fight, it's one of the most ridiculous, coolest, two old men beating each other up cutscene. You know, it's crazy, like, they're beating each other up, and just like, I'm just wondering, like, whoa, like, I'm watching this. It's one of the most interestingly choreographed cutscene ever. And there's some inspiration from Twin Snakes added there in the end. And then the two men are like, they stick each other in the neck to help each other out. And then the health bar comes up. It's just like, oh, I actually get to play it. You know, because I've been watching this whole time, and you play it. And the boss, and the fight itself is still as cinematic when you're playing it. You know, there's all these, like, fancy moves that the two do. There's a couple of things that the Ocelot will do. And he changes his moveset. I mean, this boss fight is just total fan service. It's just like a nostalgia trip, right? Even including the music, the moveset, and just the way Ocelot kind of interacts with you while you're playing. You're on top of this, this gigantic submarine. And there's this amazing graphical area, like, just like eye candy, fan service, such an emotional impact. And then the music changes to Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater music, and it's just like Ocelot has that like CQC stance, and you're battling, the health bar changes to match each game. I can go on, you know, I could really go on about this. And then finally, after you defeat, you know, Ocelot falls down, Old Snake falls down, and they stand up again, and the music changes to main theme of Metal Gear Solid 4. And then all the health bar disappears, and just inching, crawling towards each other, and punch, punch, punch. That's all you're doing. And yet, it's so impactful. Like, you smash him in the face, there's like blood splatter on the screen. I'm just like, whoa, what's going on? You know, and then you punch him, and then he finally, Ocelot is defeated, not by Solid Snake himself, but by Foxeye, ultimately, in the end. So, that kind of begs the question, like, you know, who would have actually won the fight without Foxeye? You know, because Ocelot, like, he has that, I don't know. It was a very, like, intense boss fight, and the purpose of this boss fight is kind of nebulous, you know? Ocelot, having his agenda, Was it necessary for him to fight Old Snake at the end? Not really. But kind of going through all the storylines, piecing together all the storylines together, Ocelot wanted to fight Solid Snake for the sake of the battle itself. Again, this brings me back to the point of fighting Gray Fox. But whereas Gray Fox was kind of demented, you know, his psychology is so freaking messed up. For Ocelot, this is conscious choice. He's choosing to fight Ocelot, Solid Snake. And in that sense, he's also choosing to die. Because he pretty much, I think he has an idea that Fox Eye will kill him. You know, he's choosing to die. Why? Because of adoration of Big Boss. This is Big Boss's clone, that the only clone that managed to survive to this point. You know, and the most human of them all. He's the most flawed clone. The perfect clone is Solid Snake. Liquid Snake is the enhanced clone. But Solid Snake is the most flawed clone of the three clones. And yet, he's the one who's made it this far. He's the reason that foiled the plans of Big Boss twice, foiled the plans of Solidus and Liquid Snake to free themselves from the Patriots. And yet here he stands, and this is one final battle. To me, that's what makes the most emotional impact for me. Just graphics matter, I think. It's I don't want to admit it, but it does. Graphics really matter, and just seeing that, you know, the picture, the cinematography, and to me that mattered a lot. The way it kind of mixes in nostalgia and all that, the different kind of the gameplay is so different in this boss fight. You know, it's not like fighting on top of Metal Gear Rex fighting against Liquid Snake in this boss fight, because that one you're still using the same method of hand-to-hand combat that you had, but the controls are completely changed in this boss fight. Just for this segment, controls were completely changed. And it was, I don't know, I really, really enjoyed that boss fight. So, those are my top 10. Tell me guys, you know, let me know what you guys think about my top 10, or if you know, how different it is from your top 10 boss fights. But, yeah, this was fun talking about Metal Gear, as always. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.